More and more, music theorists are required to deal with digital video on a regular basis. Whether to create video examples for an online journal or to create flipped classroom content, the ability to create media that serves a research or pedagogical purpose is a useful skill. In my own experience, a basic understanding of video editing tools allows for the creation of videos that have a high production value and are more useful to the intended audience. In this video, I'll demonstrate the creation of a specific type of video I have used in my own research projects that displays a written score of a music example on top of an associated video. The result is an efficient display of both the media under consideration as well as the notated version of the music being heard. I'll begin with the software tools you'll need to complete this project. This tutorial has been completed on a MacBook Pro, but most of the software I'll be using is either available for Windows or has a Windows equivalent counterpart. Creating these videos is a three-step process involving notation software, photo editing software, and animation software. There are many options available for both notation and photo editing, and while I'll be using Sibelius and Photoshop, respectively, almost any preferred software can be used as long as they have similar features to what I'll be demonstrating. For the animations, I'll be using Keynote, which is the free presentation software available on all Apple computers. PowerPoint has a similar animation feature, but it is difficult to export the final product as a standalone video. To get started, we need the music that will be placed on top of the video during playback. In this case, the music is a transcription of music from the game The Legend of Zelda: Skyward Sword. With the music engraved, the next step is to move the music into a single staff system. In Sibelius, you simply put the music in panorama view by clicking this button at the bottom of the window. If we then zoom out, we can get the entire staff system on screen at the same time. I know it looks small and illegible now, but the export process will create a high-resolution image. Using the keyboard command Option G will allow you to select the entire score for export. Keep the selection box as close to the music as possible. With that done, click on File, Export, and then select Graphics. TIFF, is the format I'll be using as it allows for the most details to be preserved in the graphic export. Make sure Graphics Selection is selected, and the dots per inch should be above 300, again to preserve the most details in the graphic that gets exported. Finally, choose a file name and a location to save the file and click Export. Step 2 involves editing the graphic so that it can be overlaid on the video. With the graphic open in Photoshop, the first step is to remove the background and make it transparent. If we skip this step, the resulting image would have a white background when placed on top of the video, leading to a result that works, but will obscure a large part of the video itself. A transparent background will allow most of the video to be visible along with the notation. So if we zoom in on the graphic a little, you can see the sharpness of the notation that was preserved in the graphic export. To remove the background, we simply click on the Select menu and choose Color Range. Notice that the cursor has now become a little eyedropper. Click on any black part of the graphic with the end of the eyedropper to select that color. Since the graphic is only black and white, we will set the fuzziness slider to its highest setting, ensuring that we select all of the notation. After clicking OK, you'll notice that only the notation and not the white background is selected. Now click on the Layer menu, New, and then New Layer via Copy. This creates a new layer above the original image that only contains the black part of the image. Deleting the original background layer will leave only the notation on a transparent background. At this point, you have a choice to make. If the video you will be overlaying is mostly bright, you can export the image with the notation still black. But if the video is mostly dark, you'll want to make the notes white before you export. To change the color of the notes, first go to the Select menu and choose All. We can select all now instead of finding a color range, since the only thing left in the image is the notation. Then go to the Image menu, Adjustments, and select Invert. Again, you only need to do this if the video you're creating is mostly dark. Now we're ready to export the image. Click on File, Export, and choose Export As. I prefer to export as a PNG, as this format allows you to preserve the transparent background and is compatible with almost any program that can display image files. Just make sure the transparency box is checked and that the image size scale is set to 100% and click Export All. Choose a file name and a location, and finally click Export. The final step is to bring the video and score together. For the purposes of this tutorial, I will assume that you already have the video file that you want to use. With Keynote open, create a new document. Choosing a widescreen format is best, as the dimensions will accommodate HD video more easily. With a new slideshow, create a new blank slide. Then drag and drop the video file onto that slide. If the video is too small or too big, adjust the size until it completely fills the slide. Next, drag and drop the file you exported from Photoshop into Keynote. Adjust the size of this image so that the notation is easily legible. Notice, however, that at this size, the notation is too long to fit on the slide completely. To get the image to scroll while the video is playing, we need to set up an animation. With the notation image selected, click on Animate, then click on Action, Add an Effect. Choose Move from the drop-down menu, and you will see Keynote adds a default move to the right, indicated by a solid red line and a ghost version of the graphic representing the final location after the move. The location of where the graphic moves can be changed by clicking on the ghost version and dragging it. In this case, move the graphic to the left until the end of the score is visible on the slide. With the location of the move set, the final step is to adjust the timing of the animation. First, click on Build Order at the bottom of the Animate sidebar. Two items will appear in this list: the video and the score graphic. Click on the video in the list and change the start option to After Transition. Then click on the score graphic and change its start option to With Build 1. This will ensure that both the video and the animation will start together. As for the timing, this will depend on the video being used, and it will take a few trials and errors to get the timing just right. In the end, the score should scroll at approximately the same pace as the music in the video. The pacing of the scroll can be controlled in the Animate sidebar by changing the duration of the move. The longer the time, the slower it will move. Should you want to delay the start of the animation, this can be controlled in the Build Order window. Select the score graphic and change the delay time to change when the score should begin moving. If you will only be using your new video animation in a presentation, for a class, or for research, then simply copy this slide into your main Keynote document. If the video is needed as a standalone video file, then make sure that the only slide in the document is this slide. Then click on File, Export To, then Movie. Make sure the playback setting is self-playing, and for the resolution, 720p should suffice for most situations. But if you want a higher quality video, choose 1080p. Click Next, then choose a file name and a location, and click Export. After Keynote renders the movie, it will be available as an MP4 video. The resulting video, though time-consuming to produce, is a great way to show both media, content, and musical notation at the same time.